take the information. When air column cools below its dew point temperature to become supersaturated, it leads to the possibility of condensation. Condensation is the process that is opposite to evaporation. If evaporation was the process of converting water to vapor state, utilizing heat, condensation is the process of converting vapor either to liquid or solid state, releasing that heat. Condensation always relates to release of latent heat of condensation. Condensation, which is converting vapor back to liquid or solid state, is classified on the basis of where the condensation is taking place. Name itself is reading where, location is our concern. So I classify condensation forms or types. Here the terms are synonym. In precipitation, they are not synonym. My condensation form or my condensation type are three: at near ground and atmosphere. At near ground relates to contact cooling. Can you suggest me the technical term in place of contact cooling? I'm giving you the mechanism, then you attempt the name of the term. Contact cooling will be applicable to when the air column remains in contact with the earth's surface, and in that contact I cool below my dew point temperature to experience condensation. The process, can you help me with
conduction?
Is it comfortable if I say contact cooling by the process of conduction will be very typical to a season?
Yes.
Only
winters.
Because during summers, number one, duration of day is lengthier. Number two, angle of sun ray is direct. Thus, number three, I'll receive more insulation throughout the day. Duration of night is shorter. Number next. Thus, before I cool down, to cool the air column up, next day will start. I will not experience contact cooling. So contact cooling related at ground and near ground condensation will be typical to low sun season only, and fog, dew we are commonly experiencing. Contact cooling is process of conduction, and this process is applicable winters only. I don't want to touch cloud right now. I just want to concentrate on at ground here. What is at ground condensation? At ground condensation is outcome of the process called conduction one. Contact cooling is the another commonly applied term too. I have made my air column cool below its dew point temperature, remaining in contact with the earth's surface. If it utilizes ground-lying objects, pebble, roof of the car, electricity wire, petals of the plant, and condensed moisture is deposited, it will be called at-ground condensation. If I am experiencing this process, deposition of condensed moisture, if I experience this process in the location where winter temperature remains over and above freezing point of water, I'll experience dew. If it is below freezing point of water, I'll experience frost. So lower latitude, lower altitude, I'll experience what?
Dew.
Higher latitude and higher altitude, I'll experience what?
Frost.
Dew. When this winter temperature or the temperature at contact cooling is over and above 0 degrees Celsius, when it is below 0 degrees Celsius, I develop frost. At ground, moisture gets deposited. But what is fog? Fog is near ground. That contact cooling has taken place. The air column cools below its dew point temperature. It utilizes aerosol and condenses. Fog, WMO defines fog to be near surface clouds. That means condensed moisture remains suspended. They are not deposited. And as the day advances, sun rays will heat up the ground, ground will heat up the air column, fog dissipates. So what is fog? Fog is near surface condensation. And what makes it different from at ground? There is no deposition of moisture. What makes it similar to at ground? It is also the outcome of contact cooling, conduction. Thus it is also typical to winters. Of course, thanks to the pollution that we have induced, pure fog we don't experience. Fog is always hazard. Reason, it is right there at the visibility level. And if I am saying it is a near surface cloud, higher the availability of moisture, denser the fog, reduce the visibility, it's always hazard. But now what we are experiencing is smog, smoke plus fog. So it has further proved to be health hazard. That is the reason always the advisory during the season that we are experiencing, no morning walks, because it will give you more health problem rather than health benefit, because we have got all pollutants at our breathing level. So fog and dew frost are contact cooling season specific form or type of condensation. They are not identified with absolute similarity. Reason, fog do not involve deposition of condensed moisture. Dew and frost is deposition of condensed moisture. Before I remove this flowchart, question is coming your way. Clouds, atmospheric, processes adiabatic cooling is commonest form or type of condensation, because it can experience throughout the year and can be experienced throughout the world, barring the exception of
Poland.
I'm waiting for answer. Clouds are commonest form or type of condensation. It was there in our flowchart. It is the outcome of adiabatic cooling. You know adiabatic cooling is rising air column. It is thus not typical to any season. I can experience cloud formation during winters. That is the reason today also early morning we experience precipitation. I can experience it during summers. So throughout the year, throughout the world, barring the exception of... You will take that much of time, I don't understand.
Polar.
Why polar region? There is no moisture, there is no rise. Yes, barring the exception of polar region, 80 to 90 degrees northern south, from 0 degrees to 80 degrees will experience cloud formation. So most commonest form or type of condensation is clouds. How to learn clouds? Definition and types. I am quickly writing, copy it down. So we will save our time. We have seen all these types of things. Height I am removing because I have to adjust the diagram here. Height automatically will get as we are taking this. Boundary line cannot be absolute, so dotted line. Clouds are visible aggregates of tiny ice crystals and minute water droplets. Why tiny and minute are boldly written and underlined? Because we want to prove that they are too small to form. They remain suspended in air. They don't fall. Tiny and minute is representing they are so small that they can defy gravity. We all can see clouds, so definition becomes very evident. Visible aggregate. Because it's a form of condensation, so it has to be ice crystals and droplets, because vapor has got condensed. We classify clouds on the basis of three. Number one, their shape, we have got three types of cloud. Globular masses of clouds are called cumulus. Sheet clouds that tends to overcast the sky are called stratus. And thin broken fibrous clouds are called cirrus. We also classify clouds on the basis of weather effectivity. How many can be there? Bad weather. Can you give me a definition of bad weather? Bad weather. Turbulent weather. Strong wind, rise, thundering, lightning, heavy precipitation. Bad weather clouds are called. Three names. I'll just add two more names. Bad weather clouds are called nimbus clouds. The other categories can include fair weather, and rain bearing. Names will follow. Let it remain right now. Rain bearing. So three names of the clouds, cumulus, stratus, cirrus. Fourth name of the cloud, nimbus. We classify clouds also on the basis of their height. On the basis of height, clouds are classified into three. Low altitudinal, mid altitudinal and high altitudinal. Mid altitudinal clouds are called, fourth and the final name, alto clouds. Now I am creating, we need to learn 10 cloud names, only 10 cloud names, carefully, recognize the shapes. Low altitudinal cloud number 1 is cumulus. Low altitudinal cloud number 2, I am globular. And I am overcasting the sky. It is a stratocumulus. Stratus combined with a cumulus. Yes? Recognize the shape. Because more I'll rub, more it will become white. So I'm on purpose drawing the separate lines. Stratus. Right? And now, cumulonimbus. These are conventional symbols, we can utilize that in our answer writing. And darkest. So I'm shading it as much as it is possible. Kindly attend the name. Bad weather cloud. Nimbostratus. be here for a while. Which are the five low altitudinal clouds? Column 1. It is cumulus, it is stratus, combine them. It is strato cumulus and two bad weather clouds. Name them. Cumulonimbus, nimbostratus. I am in mid height. What is the name for mid heighted clouds are? Alto. I am drawing the shape, try to recognize it. Alto cumulus. This will be alto cumulus and alto stratus. Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
And now, which is the cloud in column 1 that we have not at all touched?
Cirrus.
Recognize the shape. It should be called?
Cirrus.
It is cirrocumulus. As thin that it is invisible. Come on, name it.
Cirrostratus.
Very good. Cirrostratus. And this will be? All bad weather clouds has to be rain bearing. So cumulonimbus and nimbostratus is already written. Can you help me with fair weather clouds? Which of the 10 clouds written in front of you should be fair weather and why? Members of cirrus family. Reason, I'll be reaching that level only by, careful, adiabatic cooling, dew point temperature, condensed, release of latent heat, further rise, cooling, condensing. That means I'll reach that level by shedding my moisture at variable height. At that level, it is very difficult for me to generate precipitation. High altitudinal clouds are always fair weather. That means they don't cause rain. So how many are absolute match? Nimbus cloud is always bad weather and cirrus family members are always fair weather. So how many cirrus family members are there?
Three.
Cirrus, cirrocumulus and cirrostratus. Stop writing, give me the name. I have given you again the name of five clouds. I have told you only 10 clouds we need to understand and retain. Rest of the five names left out can be rain bearing. Start giving me the names. Cumulus cloud, stratus cloud, strato cumulus cloud, they are in the low heighted, plus alto cumulus and alto stratus. Anyhow, any of the reference. How many types of clouds we believe in? 10. How do we classify these 10 types of cloud? On the basis of their height. Which are the low altitudinal clouds? It is cumulonimbus, nimbostratus, cumulus, stratocumulus and stratus. Which are the mid altitudinal clouds? Cumulus, stratus with alto. Which are high altitudinal clouds? Cirrus with cirrostratus and cirrocumulus. Or how do we classify clouds? We classify clouds on the basis of their weather effectivity. How many types of clouds are there? 10 again, categorized into 3. Bad weather clouds are nimbus. Fair weather clouds are cirrus. And rest of the clouds will be rain bearing. It's not a difficult task. This diagram is easily available in NCERT. Very pet diagram of NCERT. Any print of NCERT will give you this diagram. What if I encounter a question that arrange the 10 clouds in increasing order of height. I know 5 of them are low altitudinal. I know 2 of them are mid altitudinal. I also know 3 of them are high altitudinal. But if 3 of them high altitudinal is to be arranged in terms of their height, 5 of them low altitudinal is to be arranged in terms of their height, there has to be certain logic to it. Are we comfortable till here? Clouds are visible aggregates of tiny ice crystals and minute water droplets. WMO's definition. Visible aggregate of tiny and minute because they are too small to fall. Clouds, because are the commonest form of condensation, takes the maximum orientation of the study of condensation. Clouds are classified on 3 bases. Nutshell, we should be aware of 10 types of clouds, and I hope we are aware of it. Just enlarging our understanding of cloud. What we are saying is, formation of cloud, I am maintaining this diagram, formation of clouds do not guarantee precipitation. We are learning that, plus, what is the logic with which I can arrange the 10 clouds written in front of me as altitudinal grade? Or what is the reason with which we say that bad weather clouds are always confined in low altitude? Why they don't go to high altitude? Or why cumulonimbus cloud has got such towering heights? Now, to understand it, there are new terms for us to interpret. Because I will be requiring bigger size, I am beginning from absolutely base. Carefully understand what I am doing. You have to help me with certain names. This is my warm surface. This is the set of two arrows. What should I write with it? What are these two arrows showing?
Rising
convection. Subjected to adiabatic cooling. Yes, all of us, this is convection. By default, I have experienced adiabatic cooling and I have condensed. The cloud looks like cumulus. Release of latent heat. Release of latent heat. I get further energy to rise. So I am quickly drawing, and quick succession I am drawing. Few set of arrows with red color within cloud. Release of latent heat, I get the energy to rise. I grow further. I further condense, further release latent heat, I continuously grow. I am repeating it till the height I can reach. Let it be done. These arrows in clouds are not convection. They are attempt the definition of updraft. Updraft. Rise within cloud due to release of latent heat. What will facilitate this sequential updraft in a cloud? What will be the prerequisite for me to experience the sequential updraft in a cloud? Higher water vapor. For me to sustain higher water vapor, what is the requirement in terms of temperature? Water vapor holding capacity is dependent on temperature. I'll be experiencing consecutive updraft because I could release latent heat at that many times. Is equal to I was holding huge amount of water vapor, is equal to I was having dash temperature. High temperature. Does it sound convincing then that such sequential updraft will be typical only to lower latitude? Yes, all of us. And is it convincing that all cumulonimbus cloud originally was cumulus, but all cumulus cloud do not grow to become cumulonimbus? What will make a cumulus cloud grow to become cumulonimbus? Updraft. What will decide sequential updraft? Release of latent heat. What will decide sequential release of latent heat? Moisture content. Comfortable? If I have taken this logic into account, before I complete this diagram is incomplete. Can you apply that logic here and attempt the grading of clouds in terms of its height? First cloud with the lowest height has to be cumulonimbus. Reason? Such high moisture content that minor rising it will condense. Yes, no.
Yes,
that
no.
Is the reason it is having such sequential latent heat release. So minor rise and it has to condense. So the lowest altitudinal cloud should be. My diagram is already showing it. You just need to now recognize it. Lowest altitudinal cloud should be cumulonimbus. Next in the height should be bad weather, nimbostratus. And then follow safely. Cumulus are globular. Without any doubt have got vertical growth. Will always be first to develop. So, next in height. Next in height. Cumulus. Next in height. Stratocumulus. Next in height. Stratus. Continue. Next in height. Altocumulus. Altostratus. Cirrocumulus. Cirrostratus. Cirrus. Yes, no. Simple logic. Which cloud will always have lower base? Vertical grown clouds. Which are vertical grown clouds? Cumulus. Which is vertical most grown cloud? Cumulonimbus. By default, it has to have the lowest base. What is the rationale with which we are saying it has to have lowest base? High moisture content, minor most rise, it has to condense. But only thing where we are placing stratus cloud prior to cumulus is nimbostratus because it is a bad weather cloud. Yes? Now careful. Our definition of cloud was, cloud is visible aggregate of tiny ice crystal and minute water droplets because both crystals and droplets are too small in size to form. These are my crystals and these are my water droplets. They are, every cloud is visible aggregate of crystals and droplets. They are too small to form. Within cloud, raindrop forming process takes place. Grandparents, grandmother story also says that dark color cloud bears rain. Because darker color clouds is equal to denser availability of condensed particles. They will be mutually merging with each other. And thus will be growing in their size. Yes, all of us? Two things I am writing. I'll explain Bergeron in a while. My ice crystals and droplets are mutually merging and thus grows in their size and start falling. The fall, as these red arrows, is not precipitation. It is downdraft. And once it is from the base of the cloud, then it is precipitation. Vertical clouds will have strong updraft, strong downdraft. If I am a sheet cloud, will I be having updraft and downdraft? No. clouds which are visible aggregates of tiny ice crystals and minute water droplets are classified on three bases, giving us 10 different types of clouds. We have understood that clouds at low height, clouds at mid height, clouds at high height are classified in accordance not just to their height but also in terms of their shape combined. Learning clouds, there is very important thing for us to learn is that clouds formation do not guarantee precipitation. Every cloud involves aggregate availability of crystals and droplets both, irrespective of the climatic condition where the clouds are getting developed. It's myth, it's wrong that if I am developing cloud, India is a warmer climate, so cloud developed over India will only have droplets. No, every cloud will have droplets and ice crystals. I am coming up with very important thing. Everything you have written, please concentrate. Clouds which have got two constituent, one is droplet, two is crystal. Crystals have got two process of growth. Droplets have got only one process of growth. Droplets grow with their size in their size because of mutual merger. As and how the droplets will merge with each other, they will grow in size. Grown in size, they will start falling. If the cloud is of vertical dimension, there will be downdraft, otherwise straightforward precipitation. Now coming to crystal. Ice crystals in cloud tends to grow by two processes. Number one, mutual merger. And number two, by the process of deposition. Deposition is opposite of sublimation. Sublimation was the process where I was converting solid straight to gaseous. Deposition is when I am converting gas straight to solid. Crystals are those condensed particles that have got lesser vapor pressure than droplets. So crystals are more attracting vapor. Vapor coming in attraction with condensed crystal will readily get deposited. That is, they will get converted from their vapor to solid state. That means crystals are growing in size, number one due to merger and number two due to deposition. This process was explained by Bergeron, thus we also call it Bergeron process. Apply that logic to this diagram. We know that such type of cloud will develop only in lower latitude. Supposedly the cloud has got height of 12 kilometers, it's a cumulonimbus cloud, and from there my mindset says lower latitude cloud should have droplets. I believe in it. Droplets merged at that height, subjected to downdraft, will it not be that it will fail to precipitate? In its downdraft, it will get adiabatically warmed up to get re-evaporated. Why lower the latitude, more the precipitation? Because lower the latitude, towering the clouds have bigger ice crystal. Big ice crystal falling, adiabatic warming, small ice crystal falling, snow falling, rain. If it would have been only droplets, then maximum would have got re-evaporated. Comfortable? So, which cloud will, I'm coming up with a question, which cloud will be called, which cloud will be related to, clouds will be related to this effective up and down draft? I want only one term. Cumulus members. Perfect matches with cumulonimbus, also with cumulus, altocumulus, the stratocumulus, and of course cirrocumulus, but dominantly with cumulonimbus. What is the difference between convection rise and updraft? Updraft is within the cloud due to release of latent heat. Convection is rise of the air column. What is the difference between downdraft and precipitation? Condensed particle falling within the cloud will be called downdraft, and from the base of the cloud will be called precipitation.